Hello,
and welcome to the third of February. So I'm going to sit here and do my nails because I'm going to do a video on. I do part two of when Rico and I met. So I'm going to talk about the wedding this time. Is what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna put my base coat on, which is OPI Nail Envy. It's what I'm using. My nails haven't been great, but they've started now again to grow. I think what was ruining my nails was this Essie oil. I think that was making my nails too soft, and probably because I don't just put it around the cuticles, I was kind of putting it all over my nails as well, and I couldn't understand why my nails were breaking because they were long and they were just too soft and were breaking. So so I think it's that. It was actually Lux and Roses that kind of gave me the idea, because she was struggling with her nails at one point and felt, you know, they weren't quite right, and she thought it was an oil from Boots that she was using. And she kind of said it to me, we were just chatting, and I never thought anything of it. And it wasn't until I think I went to do my nails, I was like, I wonder. And I think it is that. So I've stopped using it. I do use a little bit now and again around my nails, but I do feel when I do that, it softens them. So I'm going to try and not use it at all unless they start getting quite brittle. Okay, so I'm gonna do the follow-up video. Oh, and the last time I spoke to you was when I was colouring my hair. That was last night. But see, I never know what's gonna be on what vlog until I sit down to edit, because I never kind of finish off the vlogs by saying cheerio, because I just don't know how much footage, especially this time around, my vlogging has been kind of all over the place, because, you know, we're in full lockdown, so really there isn't that much going on. Although, if I had to be honest, do I ever have much going on? Which is a good thing. You know, I've learnt that in my old age, that, you know, just simplicity and no drama is a good place to be, you know. Remember when we were younger and it was, oh, I'm bored, nothing's happening, da, da, da. No, I'm happy when nothing is happening. I am more than happy when nothing is happening. Do you know, I was really, really surprised at how much everybody enjoyed the story of how Rico and I met, because I was gonna, you know, when I got asked the question, it was like, really? We met? And, you know, but apparently you all enjoyed it and you want the follow-up to it, which I think is much more interesting. Much more interesting. I don't know what will go up first. I think that will go up before this vlog. Yeah, that will go up before this vlog. So you will have seen that Rico and I actually got married twice. We did. Okay, I'm gonna leave that one right there. I'm gonna do that horrible, horrible, horrible thing that YouTubers do, and they'll say, I'll link the, well, they actually say I link the video up here, but I don't like to link videos up here. I like to link anything I like to link, anything I like to link in my description box. So you know how to get into my description box, don't you? You kind of tap on that bit just underneath there where it's my name, and then it drops the description box, and you can see everything that I've linked in there, just in case you didn't know. So yeah, I don't think people, because if you link something here, so what's somebody going to do, stop watching the video that they're watching to go there? And no, so I think it's a much better idea. I'll link it below. When you finish watching this one, you can go and watch that one. I don't know what one I was talking about. Was I talking about the one that I'm going to do? I'll tell you what. If this video is up, I will link the one of how Rico and I met and the one that I'm going to film right now. Okay. So, oh man, I am so all over the place. Yeah. So, I coloured my hair last night. Well, Rico and I coloured our hair So, Rico helped me colour my hair last night. Neither of us were up for it. Really, really couldn't be bothered. So, I just put the Oracle through it, and I'm rather pleased, even if I do say so myself. I have really, really struggled to use this Oracle thing, and it's supposed to be the easiest thing to use. I don't know. I've had this now for a year, a whole year, this Oracle curler, and it's just, it's like you have to hold it at a certain angle, and you have the I don't know what happened tonight, and I thought, I'm going to give it a try. I never even thought about it. Normally I sit and watch YouTube video after YouTube video of how to use this blinking thing. This tonight, I just got it out, I plugged it in, and I went, got a bit of hair, and I went, and this curl just came out of it, and I curled the whole of this side, no problem, and I went, right, I'm going to have problems with this, let me just go for it. Honestly, yes, it's the GHD Oracle, by the way. Okay, that's the base coat on. See, I'm used to putting the oil on and rubbing the oil over my hands, but that's obviously not good for my nails. I'm gonna go in with the OPI. It's a little one. My battery is flashing. These ones don't have colours on them. And even if it does, I really can't see it, but that's what it looks like. You know, if I can see it, I will link it, but I will have to remember when I'm editing. So it's a tiny, tiny little bottle. I'll just keep talking until my battery stops, because it's going at me, and I'm talking a whole lot of nonsense. So today is Wednesday, so we know what I do on a Wednesday, don't we? We clean the fridge on a Wednesday, and what else? That's it. I did my workout, and I don't know, is anybody finding that the days going really, really quick during lockdown? I keep saying to Nicole, I mean, you look at the clock, you know, you get up, I do what I'm going to do, I do whatever I'm going to do in the morning, clean out the toilets, tidy up, you know, whatever I'm going to do, my skincare routine, which, by the way, here I go, jumping from one thing to another, loving number seven, loving number seven, loving number seven, my skin is looking fabulous, even if I do say so myself. So what was I talking about before? Yeah, so do my morning routine, do my workout, sit down, have something to eat. So I'm trying now, I am now trying this, what is it, 16-8 fasting thing. So you eat within an 8 hour period and you fast for 16 hours, which includes your sleeping time. And you do that as well, you're supposed to do that as well. It's really good to do it when you're doing the keto diet. So I find that quite easy because I'm not really a breakfast person. You know, I'm all right not to eat in the morning. So by the time I've worked out and everything, it's kind of late on. And anyway, so I have something to eat. And then before I know it, I look at the clock and it's literally 3 o'clock. And then we have to start thinking about dinner. Unbelievable how quickly. You know, you would think with lockdown and having nowhere to go or anything like that, that, you know, the days would be really, really long and really slow, but I just find my days going really, really quick, which is weird, very weird. So that's what it looks like so far. That's the kind of first coat of it. So I'll go in with a second coat, and I'm not going to be able to change my battery because I've started doing my nails. So I'm going to have to let, I was hoping to kind of just go straight into the video whilst my nails were drying, because I don't have, I won't be touching anything. And I thought they were just going to dry while I'm doing the video. I think I'm going to have to call Rico up to change my battery, which probably will cause some sort of, you know, a wee domestic, because you put the battery in the wrong way, because it's quite a, you know, there's no way I'm going to be able to do it with wet nails, no way. Okay, first coat, let's sit there. Quite amazing how much you do get left once the battery starts blinking at you. I've got my other one charged, I think it is charged, yeah, it's ready charged. We've had to cancel the Balmoral and we've not rebooked as yet. We'll wait and see when to rebook that, because our Easter is, when I say I mean the Orthodox Easter is on the 2nd of May this year, so I don't want to be going when I'm fasting. Basically, I'm going to call Rico up now to see if he can change the battery. Rico! Okay, Rico has managed to change the battery for me. I have finished my nails. I also got my glasses, put them on over my contact lenses to check the colour. It doesn't actually say a colour on it, but underneath it does say D9, D9. If anybody... Oh, my cushion's falling and I can't fix it with my fingers. If anybody's interested, that and my lipstick's a Chanel one. You know the ones in the red packaging that were out 2 years ago, I think. Because also bought me up a glass of wine. I think he's hoping I'll stay in here because the football's going to start. And then it means I don't go downstairs and start moaning that the football's on. So apparently there's football on tonight in a wee while. So he's quite excited to watch that. So while he's watching that, I will film our wedding video. Hello and welcome to the 4th. I'm wiping Doritos off my mouth. Okay. To the 4th of February. What is it, Lily? Come on. Just push the door. Come on. 4th of February. So I am getting ready to do an empties video. But I'm also stuffing myself with Doritos, because I went downstairs and I just fancied them. So you know what it's like. Once you start, you can't stop. Come on, Lily, just push the door. Hold on till I let her in. You know, she does this because I don't know what it is. She can open the door. She can jump on the bed, but she wants you to get up and look as if you're going to help her. And then the minute you get up, she does whatever she's been trying to do. What are you doing, Lily? She wants a Dorito, is what she wants. This is why I have to work out all the time. Because I'm not like any other normal person that can open a bag of Doritos and have a few Doritos and stop. I have to keep going and keep going until there's no Doritos left. Honestly. Okay. I'm going to put them away and film my empties video. I have a variety of goodies here in front of me that are empty. I even have two bottles of nail varnish, because people quite often ask me, do you actually ever empty your nail varnish bottles? I do. And if you watch my empties, you will see that I do. And you know, I think it's good to watch empties by YouTubers that are not sponsored, that are not paid, because you get a true reflection. Is that the word? I don't know. But everybody's hair, everybody's skin is different, and that's what we've got to remember. And it's trial and error. And trust me, I have trialed in error many times. Many times. Hello and welcome to the afternoon of Sunday the 7th of January. No, it's February. Oh my goodness me. It's February. Starting to go back the way. We don't want to go back the way. Okay, so we are out for a Sunday walk for our exercise. So I've decided not to run today. I did another 5k yesterday. Completed it. So that was good. But Rico and I decided it was a Sunday walk type of day. It's absolutely freezing. This is our view. And snow is starting, so we're trying to get this run done. Thank you for correcting me, Rico. Oh, trying to get the walk done as quickly as possible. So I keep telling Rico to hurry up, and he's saying we're here to walk, not run. But yeah, it's starting to get dark. Snow is starting to get just a little heavier. We have Lily here.
that lily right here. Yes, she, ah, come on. She's got her red jacket on today, which makes her walk sideways. Oh. So there's quite a few people here today, which is quite surprising, but then it's quite surprising because it's late in the afternoon and it's really, really cold. But like Rico said, what else is there to do during lockdown but go visit a park and walk? We are in Strathclyde Parks at the moment. Oh, I'm just not a happy person. I need them for my ears. So that's us. Rico yesterday went to help Luke move out of one flat to another flat. So that's what Rico spent his day doing yesterday. Yeah, that's our news. Okay, we have walked all the way around. It's about 6 kilometres all the way around. Look at that. It's really starting to get quite dark. It's about 5 o'clock just now, just after. And yeah, looks as if the ducks and the swans, looks as if the ducks and the swans are all getting a wee feed. Okay, that's us home. We have eaten and I was supposed to do a video. I was thinking of doing a video comparing the Sculpt jeans. So I've got 3 pairs. I have one from Marks & Spencer's, I have one from Primark, and I have one from Next. So I was going to compare them and tell you which ones are the best. Oh, I'm tired. But as you can see, I'm not up for it. I'm just not up for it. The warm and the cold air and all that took it out of me. I haven't even closed my rings tonight and it's not going to happen because I'm nowhere near it. So that's not going to happen. Just watching In The Froze vlog and she was waiting to hit 1 million. Oh, sorry. I know it's so annoying watching somebody on. Watching herself hit 1 million subscribers on YouTube. And the numbers were going up by the hundreds. And I'm like, really? It's like, oh my God. Like, my numbers go up. I'm lucky if I get one new subscriber a day. But I was just thinking that would be great just to see the numbers going up like that. Imagine like watching the numbers go chicka-chicka-chicka-chicka. That would be great. Let's talk about YouTube and numbers as we're here. So my channel has actually been really, really slow in growing. For me, you know, and I know these girls work a lot harder because it's their career. And for me, it's obviously a hobby, something that I enjoy doing. But it's also, I'm not gonna lie, it's satisfying to watch the subscriber number go up and to watch your views go up. So when you have really good views, it's really good. Some of my videos have a lot of views. And I know it's the minute. All I have to do is upload a video about Cartier or Chanel and the views will go up, especially Cartier or Tiffany. I cannot stop yawning. I think I should stop talking because I'm just tired. But, and I know that's what gets the views. I also know because my channel has got such a variety of content. So I vlog, I talk about luxury, I do Primark calls. So basically my channel is all over the place and that's not good. YouTube kind of then are like, so what is this channel about? So you know, they have difficulty kind of recommending your channel, and I know that, but I also would, I just feel that's me being real to me, that's what I'm about, that's what my life is. It's not about handbags, although I love handbags, which is another subject in itself, because
I was having a discussion with a friend yesterday, and we were talking about the luxury community and how real it actually is. Now, I'm not coming down on the luxury community here, or, but it's, you know, we convince ourselves because we watch so many people unboxing bags and buying bags and all of that, that that's reality and it's okay to do that. But is it? Because that isn't real life. Buying a handbag, like the way some of these people are buying handbags, it almost feels like you're made to feel like it's a normal thing to do, and it actually isn't. You know, we need to, and you know, I was saying to my friend, I'm not going to mention her name because I don't know if she wants everyone to know that we had this conversation, but I said to her, we were talking about even perfumes. I used to have one perfume, and that was my signature scent. That was my perfume. And then you kind of move on maybe to a winter perfume and a summer perfume, and that's it. Okay, that's as good as it got, and that was good enough. But then, and when we were talking about it and having a lot of perfumes, I said to her, well, I honestly felt as if, because once I became a YouTuber, once I became part of this community, I felt I needed a tray full of perfumes. But actually you don't, and I know some people love perfumes, and that's the thing. It's like me, I love nail varnishes. I'm contradicting myself, because that would be the same about somebody that loves handbags. Yeah, I'm definitely contradicting myself. I suppose it's different, the money that you spend on a bottle of nail varnish to the, oh, I'm too tired. I'm talking rubbish. I've now realised I'm talking rubbish. I should just go and get my pyjamas on, do my skincare, my number 7 skincare, and just chill, because I'm really feeling tired. I think I question myself too much about handbags. Talking of which, I was using my very old Gucci messenger bag today as a crossbody, which was this bag. I now know that this bag and my big winter coat, or any crossbody and my big brown winter coat that I was wearing today on the walk, do not go, because that has a big puffed collar. I'm trying to get this over that, and oh, I was getting annoyed. It was too, oh, too hard to get on and off, and it was annoying me. So I've now learned that, I can't stop running, that coat and this bag do not go. I think it's all that fresh air down by the loch. I think it's just tired behind. Right, Andrew, shut up.